send a memo and a copy of the terminal forecast from the weather service and from Skyline 08. Yeah, John, they don't match at all. They're two just totally different.
Talking on the PA, what's she saying? Well, why was she doing
it
with the door open? Yeah, go ahead, Mike.
Yeah, for example, John, on the weather forecast we gave you, between 17:35 and 18:18 tomorrow, the highs they're indicating on the forecast is 1500, and that's with Skyline LA. And the one I have, the weather service showing that we have, between 2200 and 0400, 3500 overcast.
Okay, I'll check and see what the dispatcher is making out on that. Back. The stairs are all back there and everything up there, Mike.
Roger. They're still doing the head count. Hang on.
No, that's fine. I just was just checking. I could hear it talking back there. What they were talking about. Was that sound like part of her briefing?
Yeah, it did to me.
How's her briefing?
Well, I think maybe no one's there and the door's open and the stairs are there is what I'm thinking might be going on. Three is clear, so I'm going to go to high again.
Okay, three is clear and three is select.
Thirty. It's slow showing. And there was our taxi games. Yes, flaps to 78 taxiing before taking off.
Twice.
Turn short on the left.
Left. 78 Mach.
Clear
by it.
Three people travel on the bottom.
Take off. San Francisco, let's call our speed limit. Not speed 1 PR. We pass 34 on speed. No function for RP 1. Port. Snitch fair from no function. You can't expect to clear right. Engine on command of port.
I'm going to turn sideways a little bit on the road just to get downwind.
Next
check. What is coming?
Five
cars. I think it's in a row.
off at 3-2, I didn't get our out time though.
Here's like your windshield heat and your pedo heat and all that stuff, fast seatbelt signs.
Uh-huh.
Here's all your outside lights and so forth.
Yeah.
And these buttons are used to feather and unfeather the propeller.
Yes.
But they're the electrical portion, if you pull these handles, they do that plus about 13 other things mechanically.
Wow.
And down the center here is, this is the start panel.
Yes.
Bleed air that opens up and so forth.
Yes.
And then the switches that turn the ignition on and off, the selector to decide which one to start.
Uh-huh.
And the actual start button to start it.
I see.
Cockpit voice recorder, and then over this panel over here is the cabin pressurization.
Yes.
Which just has the controller and also indicating cabin rate of climb and altitude and so forth. And all along here is radio buses, battery selector, and standby inverters.
Yes.
Over here is the shows the voltage, amps, and which buses are powered at any given time.
Yes.
And these are the actual generator switches up there.
Yeah.
And back here is just a trip, for trip voice recorder and that sort of stuff like that over there. That's pretty much it on that upper panel.
Where can you get nowadays Electra training? If somebody wants to, for example, fly an Electra, where does he get the training?
Well, where there's a place that has all of it down is called STI, Simulator Training Incorporated,
yes.
Down in Seattle. And so you can go through that, and they have a simulator there, but then you have to find someone with an aircraft to fly if you need like a type rating.
Yeah.
And so they either come to us, or used to be Zantop, but they've gone out of business,
yeah,
I guess.
Right.
And then another new Electra operator is Linden.
Yes.
Suppose you could go to Linden and get it too.
This is from Western.
Now when you get something like KLM, I think that was a mod. Where it's laid out of the valley.
Oh, yeah, for sure. That must have been.
Got some of these Electras over in England, don't they?
Yes.
Channel right. Hunting our cargo.
Call on the portion, please.
Provo about 7 a.m.
Over
you might even do is stay at 10.
Until we get past these mountains?
Well, until we get to about 20 out or so, maybe, and then we'll pull the plug. It looks like it's going to be good VFR, there's no doubt about it. And you just do whatever's necessary.
That wasn't discretion of 7, though, was it?
No, I'll have to put up with them, I think. Present speed, we're still 7 minutes to the VOR. All we need is 1,500 feet of wind to get ground clear out of the VOR, much less the whole traffic pattern and everything else, you know.
American 129, radar contact, crossing 153 left. American 129, climb maintain, funnel 350.
Center, 3186, understand, have the important site, clear visual approach, Dillingham Airport, change advisor for
flight you want to do now.
Down below your 190 so you can have all your gear and stuff available as you want it.
Okay. Fine. You're back down below. Making sure we're talking the same language here.
Oh, we are. I got the runway dial in here.
I got it.
That's the one I have over there?
Yeah, the town's over there.
Uh-huh. I see the runway, yeah.
chat the globe going the other way, it's not back.
This guy, yeah.
The reason for turbulence is low speed. The speed drops.
For what?
If the speed drops, is that the reason for turbulence?
No.
No.
Just wind, yeah?
Just wind.
Okay.
Yeah, we got traffic. Reeve for 186 is on the high right now. One nine is right one.
Customers live cross check pretty good, coming up on 1,000. Mozzies were already on. Alright, you're on the Mozzies.
I got 5-2.
got your APU.
Taxi, Andy, if you want to come out. Okay, thank you. Welcome.
Thank you very much.
Echoing your radio, remember 205 was on the taxi with Juliet. What do you start for you? That 2054 also AM radio. Traffic cheering from taxi is clear. Good back at 2-1. Okay, thanks a lot.
Gotta be open here.
I guess we don't know if there's a pallet coming on or what, huh?
I have no idea. Yeah, we got A open still.
Okay.